This is the MQ-135 air quality sensor, and I've got it hooked up to the analogue input there. You can see AO on the bottom left. I don't need the DO, that digital output, and that would be associated with this green light and the screw. I'm not using that today. Basically, the digital is more like it detects something, it doesn't detect something. If it does, the green light comes on. If it doesn't, the green light goes off, right? That's sort of just jammed on because it's not in use at the moment. I'm using AO, which will not only detect something, but it will give me a kind of a score between 1 and 1,000-ish, probably 1,024, as to how smelly things get with these volatile organic compounds that it might pick up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just start up this program. I've written a little, very simple program, and all it does is it takes three values, gets the average, and then reads it. So right now, it's giving me a steady-ish 211. Out of what, you ask? Out of how smelly it is. I mean, maybe outside would be better, but right now, it's 212, 215, 211. Yeah, it's about that, right? So let's see if you can detect some hand sanitizer. So it definitely smells some residual stuff. And this hasn't been used in a few minutes. So I'm just going to squirt. Oh my gosh, this went everywhere. Some onto my hand. And now let's just see what it picks up. Okay, it's basically... oh my God, it's completely freaked out. It's now 530, 498, 530, 576. I should say as well that this is connected to pin one here. My program. So the analog is connected to the pin one, basically this guy in the market bit. Now you could use crocodile clips to it, but I've got this nice breakout board. And then the other two, well, it's your usual voltage. Now this thing here is rated for 5 volts. I'm pretty sure I might wreck it or damage it or maybe it's not very good when it's running off 3 volts from a micro bit. But you know, I mean, it's hooked up to a USB. Maybe that'll give a little bit of a kick. But it seems to work okay, you know? Like, you could see it freaked out there. It did something, you know? So, but it really should be hooking up to 5 volts and not 3 volts because of what the sensor was designed for. So the power here is going to be the red going to the red and the brown to the black. Now, what does that actually mean? Well, if you look here, you can see... that I've hooked up the brown to GND, which is ground, which kind of makes sense because that's the ground. Okay, so there's ground in the micro bit, and there's also ground here, which is the black pins. They're connected, and the red is VCC, your voltage, and that is the red here, and it's also 3 volts in the micro bit. So if I was to plug that out and look at how I would do this with crocodile clips, I'd hook up the signal there to pin one, the AO analog output. My 3 volts, I'd hook that crocodile clip up to VCC, and my ground would be ground there, that one there. The breakout board just lets you do all those little ones in between, but that's fine. Right, let's do the code for this. The code I'm using here, I've written a little bit of a code with blocks. Just it takes the value of the analog signal from pin one on the marker bit there, takes it 3 times, then it adds them together and divides by 3 to get the average. That just stops any kind of sudden crazy spikes coming up in the data. So I'm also using this yellow block just to speed up the flow of text going by. You could actually just go into Python and see this 50 here. You can adjust that. I think by default it's like 100, but I found it real slow. So first I edited it in Python, and then it came up here, Python block. I thought that might be confusing. So I looked through extensions, and you can find an extension in there called, there it is, scroll text. And that way you can actually have a super fast text or a super sideways text. There you go. Then I write the serial here. Right to serial, the value of the analog signal. Let's have a look at it there by clicking
Show console device. I've got this paired up to the micro bit, by the way, and that's why I can read from it. Here's my micro bit here. Okay. So actually, if I move it in front of my breath, it can detect the kind of gases that I'm expelling by breathing upon it. It's going up and down. Let's see if I take some of this hand sanitizer. If I move this nearby, will it detect that as it is? Yeah, it can't even. Look, I haven't even opened the thing, and it is going up. Okay, so it really depends now. This doesn't necessarily mean I'm just gonna unscrew the hand sanitizer here. Like if I just take the tube of this and put it underneath, it should shoot right up. So let's just say it should be good up now. If I just move this up and down here. Yeah. Oh yeah, there we go. Wow, look at that. It doesn't like that, does it? So I can see there, right, that it shot up a lot. So all that stuff previously seems like background rubbish now that I got that huge hit from that alcohol hand sanitizer, and it's going to go back down. So if I was to make a sensor that would detect whether hand sanitizer is nearby or whether someone's breathing on it, they'd be two different levels. So really you just need to bring it into the background and go, well, I noticed, for example, I'll make up a number, if it went above 200 when I was breathing on it from 200 to 220, I can be like, okay, anything over 210, someone's probably breathing the sensor. Look at that, it's a breathing sensor, okay? If it freaks out and goes up to 800 with alcohol, I go, okay, if it reads above 800, then alcohol is present. Do you know what I mean? So that's how you could sort of write code for this. You're just using the if block. So if analog read one is bigger than a number, set up an alarm, have some text, lights, disco, all that jazz. So that's it. That's all how to do this on a micro.